guys, welcome to Simplified Coding again, and we are learning about Firebase real-time database. So in the last video we related two nodes together using the ID, as you can see on the database. This artist has these two tracks. So in this video we will fetch these tracks in the Android side. So what we'll do, we will do the same thing that we did while fetching the artist list. So first we need to create a new list for that track. So again we will create a new class and we will name it track list. Now we also need a custom layout that we created for displaying the artist list. So we can just copy the same list and paste it here. So change the name to track list. That's it. Now for the tracks we have name, track name and track rating. So just change the ID to rating and this is it. Now come inside the class track list. This class will extend array adapter and it will take track. Now instead of writing the whole code, we can copy it from the artist list class and we can just copy the code from here. Just copy everything and paste it here. That's it. Now the list will be of track type and we will also change the object name with tracks, and here also track and tracks. And then the layout would be layout, track list, and then tracks, and here this dot tracks equals to tracks, and the constructor name would be track list, and here also we will have track, track equals to tracks dot get. Now here we will write track dot get track name and track dot get track rating, and it is an integer, so we will cast it to or convert it to string. We'll write a string dot value of and get track rating. That's it. Now change it to text view rating and here it will be text view rating and text view rating. That's it. So we have the track list. Now come inside add track activity. So this is our activity. Here we need to define a list that will hold the list of tracks. So we will define list and the type would be track and tracks. Now import list. That's it. Now inside on create we will initialize the tracks equals to new array list. That's it. Now we will override the on start method. So right click, generate, override methods and on start. That's it. Now inside on start we will add a add value event listener to our database reference to detect the value changes. So we will write database tracks dot add value event listener and here we'll write new and we have the value event listener. Now on data change we will get all the values that is inside the particular artist. So first we will clear all the previous values using the clear method of list. Then we will loop through all the values. So we will write for, then database snapshot, data snapshot, and then track snapshot, or you can write data snapshot, track snapshot, and we will get the snapshot from this data snapshot object. So we'll write data snapshot dot get children. That's it. Now we will get all the tracks from the snapshot using track equals to track snapshot dot get value, and we will pass our track class. That is the model. Now we will add this track to our list. So we will write tracks dot add and then the track object. So we have all the tracks here. Now we will create a new adapter using the tracklist class. So we'll write tracklist adapter equals to new tracklist. We will pass the current activity context, so we can use add track activity dot this and then our tracklist, which is tracks. That's it. Now we will add it to our list view tracks dot set adapter, and we will pass track list adapter. That's it. Now just try running the application. So we have these artists. Now select an artist and there is some error. Let's check what it is. So we have a null pointer exception on track list. So let's check what is the problem. Oops, here we have artist list. It should be layout track list. Now that's it. Run again. And select it again, and you can see we have the two tracks added for Atif Aslam. Now you can check by adding more tracks, like and click on add, and you can see the track is added on the list. And you can also check the Firebase console, a new node is generated. So that's it for this video, friends, and in the next video we will learn about updating the existing data in Firebase database. Meanwhile, please like this video, subscribe to my channel, click on the bell icon to get the notification updates, and also share this video to your social networks, and we will meet in the next video. Thanks for watching.